Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we were studying about the IUPAC rules of the derivatives of the benzene, that is mono, di and tri, and based on that we are going to name that is the IUPAC nomenclature for the structures that are being provided to us. So let us do that. So now we are going to give the IUPAC nomenclature to the structure that have been provided to us, and they are basically aromatic compounds. So starting with the first one, so this is the structure that we have and for which we have to give the IUPAC nomenclature. But the thing is, this is a disubstituted benzene, and for which how and from where the numbering would start, that is the main thing. So in alkanes also we have studied that the numbering should be done in such a manner that it should be in an alphabetical order. So in that case, suppose in the both the cases, suppose if I take the number, that is suppose if I consider this as carbon number 1, this would be carbon number 2, 3 and 4, I would get a number as 1, 4. But if I give it number from this side, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, again I am getting 1, 4. So from where should I consider the numbering? Again, for this the alphabetical order is the one that could help us out. So therefore the bromine is the one, or the bromine atom, it starts with an alphabetical P. So that is the iodine, it starts with I. So therefore according to the alphabetical order, we'll give it the number to this one as 1. So therefore this one would be the second, third and fourth. Even in this term also we could analyze that what would be the name of or what would be the IUPAC name of that particular compound. So therefore according to this, the name of this would be that is 1-bromo, then there it is 4-iodo and benzene. So therefore the name is 1-bromo-4-iodo benzene. So now let us talk about the another one. So I hope this is the one that has been cleared, and where we have substituted where we have given the correct numbering to the bromine atom and the iodine atom or the substituents. Now let us move on to the next one that we have, that is this one. And yes, it is again a disubstituted benzene, and for which we have to give the numbering. But if you observe that I could give the number from that is NO2 also. Suppose if this is the carbon number 1, carbon number 2, this one would be carbon number 3. And the numbering should not be in this manner where carbon number 1, carbon number 2, 3, 4, 5. Then this term, when we give it in a anticlockwise, in this case, not in every case, but in this case, suppose if it numbers from the anticlockwise, then obviously we will get a bigger number, that is 1, 5. And what if we have given the number from this one? That is again, and also in a clockwise, suppose if I will give it, then this one would be basically number it as basically 1, 3. But if you observe that the special group is also been present over here, that is CH3 group, and we know that benzene and CH3 are basically known as toluene. So therefore, since this is a special group that has been our special compound that has been present over here, so therefore the number 1 will be given to the carbon atom which has been attached to the methyl group over here. So therefore this is the carbon number 1. Again, I'll do in such a manner and number in such a manner where I could get the other number should also get a least number or get less number of azero ketone. So therefore this is the first carbon atom, this one would be the second, and this one would be the third. And on the third position, basically NO2 group has been attached over here, and the special compound should end with its name. So therefore I could name it as, because this would be in the prefix name, so therefore the name of this would be nitro group, and that nitro group is at present at carbon number 3. So therefore the name of this one would be 3-nitro, and the special compound is basically benzene plus CH3, basically known as toluene. So therefore the name of this is 3-nitro toluene. So this is the name, or this is IUPAC nomenclature that we have given to this compound. And now let us move on to the other one that we have, that is this one. So again we have got a disubstituted benzene, and in this case as you could see that CH3 groups are been attached. But CH3 group, when it is attached to benzene, it is basically known as toluene. So therefore the special name should be given to this one. But we have also understood that is the rules of the disubstituted benzene, which we have got to know. Suppose if both the substituent group are the same, then we should number it in such a manner that the ending should be end with the benzene. So for example, in this case, I would give the number 1 to this carbon. Again, I could give the number 1 to this carbon also, because in any direction, if you give the number, then the combination that you could get is 1,4 itself. And the both are the same, so therefore no case of priority that to whom I should give the carbon number 1 or carbon number 2, the substituents where it has been attached to. So therefore this is the carbon number 1 that we have. Again, this is 2, 3, and now this is 4. So in this case, basically the both the groups are being the same. So that is the reason we should represent those groups earlier before the word benzene. And that's the reason that I could see that both the groups are present on carbon number 1 and carbon number 4, making this to be called as 1,4 dimethyl. And the overall it consists of benzene, so therefore the name of this would be 1,4 dimethyl benzene. Simple one. Now let us move on to the next one that we have, that is this one. Now it is not a bisubstituted or disubstituted, it is a trisubstituted, as we could see. And in this case, the thing that we have to do is we have to number it. But the numbering should be in such a manner that the combination of the numbers that we have got that we have bought should be very much less. So suppose because I'm giving the different possibility that we could do, and we could also be getting a wrong name. So for that, suppose if we have numbered it from this as 1. So I can't number it this carbon as 2, because it would give a long distance to this substituents, and that will give a very larger number. So therefore the reason I have to give the number from this side only. So suppose if this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So the combination that I could get is 1,5,6, which could be a larger number. And suppose if what if I give the number from this direction, that is from this direction, that is clockwise direction, then this would be carbon number 1. Carbon number 2, carbon number 3, that is 1,2,3. It seems to be a better option. And but this is what we have got to know, that is 1,2,3 is a better option. But the numbering will start from which substituent or which carbon atom which has been attached to the substituent. Is it C2H5 or is it CH3? It is NH2. Yes, because NH2 when attached to a benzene, it is basically known as an aniline. And that is the reason that the numbering will start. Even this was a rule of the IUPAC nomenclature. So this was also the rule of the IUPAC nomenclature that reacted for the aromatic compounds, and that's the reason that this makes us to get a special compound which is known as aniline. So therefore the numbering should be done from the group NH2 itself. So therefore this one would be the group 1, this one would be the second, and this one would be the third. So therefore this is the numbering that we have did. And talking about what would be the name and what would be we would give the name to this compound. So in this case we could see that C2H5 is nothing but the ethyl group, and on the second position it has been methyl group. So we should write the methyl group first? No. We could write, but the thing is we have to also obey the alphabetic law order. So in that case, what we have got to know that this are the substituents, while this is the special compound that we have, that is aniline. So therefore we have only the two options that we have, that is C2H5 and methyl group, that is CH3. So the numbering has been done, and the thing is we have to represent it, and we have to insert a name to that. And that's the reason that on the third position is the ethyl group, it has been attached, and the ethyl starts first compared to that of the methyl in alphabetical order. So therefore we'll write it over here as 3-ethyl, 2-methyl, and the name of the aromatic compound is basically aniline. So therefore we could write it as 3-ethyl, 2-methyl aniline. So this is the name that we have for this compound, and I hope you have understood this also. So let us move on to the another one that we have, that is this one. And this is the one that we have to give the nomenclature for this compound. And yes, thing is for the substituent, I think we have got to know that we should number from which direction and from which carbon substituent. And in that case, suppose if we are talking about this one, then we should choose in such a manner that the less combination that of the numbers that we could get. So I could get a less combination number if I choose either this one or either this one. So suppose for example, suppose if I am concerned about this number, so therefore this is the carbon number 1, 2, 3, and this one would be the 4. And what if I consider this as a carbon number 1, so therefore this one would be the carbon number 1. I wouldn't choose this number after that. I would choose this number. So because the population should be less number that I could get. So therefore this is carbon number 2, 3, 4, 5. So I am not getting carbon number that is 1, 2, comma that is 4, but I am getting 1, 2, comma 5. So obviously I can't take even this one as a correct sequence of numbering. So obviously we have to choose a such a number where I could get a less combinational number. And moreover, if we could see in this case, that is OCH3 has been attached. And this OCH3, if it has been attached to benzene, that is called to be aniso. Yes, that is also a special kind of, or that is also a common name that has been approved by the IUPAC nomenclature. So that is the reason that we will give the numbering from that special substituent, or in this case is this one, OCH3. So therefore this one will be the carbon number 1, this one will be carbon number 2, carbon number 3 and carbon number 4. So this is what we have. And talking about because this is the substituent, or basically the anisole is the one that is basically the special compound that we could get, and that's the reason that we have only two options with us, so as to have a competition that which one should write first and we should write on later on. And that is the thing that ethyl is the one that it starts with E, while fluorine is the one that starts with F. Taking an alphabetical order, giving a preference to ethyl first, so that's the reason that we could write the name of this structure as 4-ethyl. And on second, it is fluoro group that is attached, so therefore 4-ethyl, 2-fluoro. And the next is basically, because it is an aniso, so therefore we could write it as aniso. So therefore the name is, we clearly mentioned over here, that is 4-ethyl, 2-fluoro, aniso. So that is the name of this compound that we have. And let us talk about the next one, that is this one. And let me give the preference. I hope you have gotten that from which we should give the number. And this is basically a tri-substituted benzene. We could say that all these all the benzene substituents are basically the same in this case. Basically, this is the bromine atom, and even all these are bromine atoms. So the numbering should start from which end, because that is the main thing. So I should choose in such a manner that the less combination of the numbers that I would get. So suppose if I choose this number as carbon number 1, then this would be carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 1, 3, 4. And what if I choose the number from this? So therefore this one will be carbon number 1, carbon number 2, 3 and 4. So among these two, 1, 2, 4 is the best option. So that is the reason I will number it in this form. That is, this is carbon number 1, 2, 3 and 4. And since all the substituents are the same itself, so that's the reason we have to represent all the substituent first, and then we will give a parent a name to this aromatic compound. So therefore the all the groups that are the same over here is basically bromo, and that are being attached on the first, second and fourth of the carbon atom of the aromatic ring, that is of the benzene. So therefore I could name it as 1, 2, 4 tri-bromo benzene. So that is the IUPAC nomenclature of this compound that we have. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and I hope you are going to subscribe to this video also. And I hope you won't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.